Ladies and gentlemen, it's now an honor for me to place my very humble request to our chief guest of this closing ceremony, Honorable Prakash Man Singh, the Deputy Prime Minister of Nepal, who is also the Minister for Federal Affairs and Local Development, for his address.
Mr. Chairman, Ms. Cristina Figueres, Executive Secretary, UN Climate Change Secretary, distinguished participants, friends from the media, ladies and gentlemen. At the outset, I express my gratitude to the organizers for providing me an opportunity to address this important conference. I would also like to extend my warm felicitations to the distinguished participants who have actively participated in this conference and shared experiences on adaptation solutions to climate change issues. I am pleased to learn that productive deliberations over the last 3 days and informative field visits have led to satisfactory conclusion of this international conference. The technical deliberations and constructive discussions held in plenary and parallel sessions have been able to concretize our idea on adaptation solutions to climate change problem and subsequently forge practical solution on financing local adaptation. These solutions, I believe, will create a platform for coordinated efforts to integrate issues on adaptation financing into the global development agenda. The world community needs to acknowledge that people and communities at least developed corners of the world do possess a good reservoir of accumulated knowledge and best practices which can be shared and applied at the national, regional, as well as international levels for achieving sustainable and people-centric development. Enhanced cooperation and a true spirit of partnership among the development agencies and the developing countries under the framework of UNFCCC and other sustainable development platforms are necessary to abate the impacts of climate change on the lives and livelihoods of vulnerable local communities. A commitment for the flow of adequate financial resources, technical know-how on the part of the developed nations will ensure a balanced development for all those living on planet Earth. I thank you all for your constructive inputs on the options for community-based adaptation and its finance aspects. Ladies and gentlemen, climate change poses a great threat to our poor and vulnerable communities. People living in the highlands and low-lying regions of the world are getting more and more vulnerable to global warming, frequency and ferocity of extreme events such as floods, droughts, and crop failures are increasing, and their effect is mostly borne by the poor community. While international actors in the UN negotiations are working to tackle these problems, people from poorer regions of the world are already facing difficulty and they don't have time to wait for the outcome of UN negotiations. People need immediate action and they are rightfully following it in their homes, fields and neighborhood and surrounding environment, as you have seen in 3 days field visit of different villages of Nepal. Learning from and sharing of such initiatives, making scientific case out of this experience and using the scientific evidence thus generated to enrich climate action is the best way forward. I believe this conference will be able to appropriately place these concerns and issues in the negotiating armor of policymakers. The conference has not only raised problems and challenges of implementing community-based adaptation, but also hinted at tremendous opportunities and potentialities with the local knowledge. The international community needs to recognize these opportunities and methodologies of adaptation and come up with enhanced policies, institutional structures, funding mechanism, and support systems. As we conclude the conference, let's collectively resolve to effectively raise our voice to plead with the world community that it needs to be more generous, that the process to assess climate funds by the parties needs to be simplified, that a higher level of cooperation is necessary to initiate trustful implementation of reducing emission and increasing local communities' adaptive capacity. Thank you, and Jenwa.